Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. If you're new here, welcome. Thank you so much for stopping by. So I've been gone for a while, for a little over a year now. Last year was really, really hard. It was a very rough year. I had, you know, a lot of good moments, but I also struggled a lot last year. But I started off this year with a new motto, and the motto is F it. So hopefully now that I'm trying to begin my YouTube thing again, hopefully I can stay consistent. I am in a much better mind frame right now. So yeah, so I said, let me try this thing one more time. So yeah, guys, today that was my little update. Not really much to say besides I was struggling mentally, but I'm in a better place now. So yeah, so I'm gonna start off my welcome back video to YouTube with my favorite products at the moment. So some of these are new, some of them are old, like, you know, my tried and true, ride or die, never gonna stop using them products. So yeah, with all that being said, let's jump right into today's video. All right guys, so I'm gonna start off in the order in which I would do my face. So a few of these things are gonna be in a haul that I'm gonna be doing next. I might be wearing the same exact clothes because I might film it now because everyone is out of the house. The kids are at a little party down the block. So I might film it after this video. So if you see anything repeated in my haul video that's coming up, then that's why. So yeah, so let me stop talking caca and jump right into my favorites. So my current favorites, sorry, because I have everything on my vanity up here. So I just want to make sure I can grab everything in the order I am saying. So the first thing I always do is my brows. Sorry if you hear my dogs barking. They're a little crazy. So yeah. So the first thing is my brows. So I used to really like, I don't know if you can see them, but you see they're like a lot more kind of feathered out. They're not so boxy how I usually do them. So I started using this Too Faced brow wig. It's a brush on hair fluffy brow gel in soft black. So I found this in TJ Maxx and I got it. So it kind of brushes on the hairs almost. It's a kind of like a fiber, I think. I don't know how well you're gonna be able to see it, but so I just kind of brush it on and then I clean it up with any concealer. Really, I have a lot of like little concealer palettes, or you know, like the cream ones, or I use a regular concealer that I'm going to use underneath my eyes. It really doesn't matter, any concealer. But I use specifically this very small detailed Morphe brush. This is what I use to clean up underneath my eyebrows and on top. And even if I put this on messily, once I clean it up, they look like this. So that's what I use. And then sometimes I feel like my eyebrows do start a little bit further apart, which I want them to start like a little bit closer. I'll go in with my favorite Morphe micro brow pencil in the shade Java. So it has the spoolie on one side and then it has like the little skinny pencil on the other side. So I use that just to draw in little bit, like little thin little hairs. So this is what I use for my eyebrows. And this you can probably get in Ulta, like the two Morphe products, or on Morphe's website, of course. I would try to link everything down below. There are a few things I won't be able to link because a few of these things I got like in TJ Maxx and stuff like that. So yeah, those are the eyebrows. Now, the next thing I usually do is my primer. So I have a couple primers here that I've been using and they're amazing. So in the summertime, I use my Milani SPF BFF primer. The bright light, hold on. So that's what it looks like. And this has a SPF of 30 and it's a primer. It is a little bit sticky and it also gives, it gives like a little bit of a glow to your skin. So I'll use this or I'll use my Wet n Wild Glass Correct Primer Base. And this is like $4 and it's so good. Like it leaves you nice and dewy and I love this so much. It literally makes your skin look like glass. And then whichever one of those two I use on top of it, I do use my Milk Hydro Grip Primer. This primer is amazing. A drugstore dupe is the e.l.f. Power Grip Primer. I had that one, but I used it all up instantly. Like, I love it so much. So I was just like, once I finish this one, I'm going to repurchase the e.l.f. one. I'll repurchase this one maybe in the future, like when Sephora has a sale. But in the meantime, once I finish this, which is, you can see I'm almost out, I'm going to repurchase the e.l.f. one because it's really, really good. I'll link this one, the Milk one, and I'll link the e.l.f. Power Grip Primer down below. You could find that one in like drugstores, Ulta, stuff like that. So then I would go in with my foundation. So the three foundations, I'm sorry, I said two, but it's three because I'm excessive. I'm so extra. Where is it? Okay, so the three foundations that I love to use right now is the Milk Makeup Blur Liquid Foundation, which looks like this. This is a matte foundation, and I have mine in the shade Medium Tan. This matches me perfectly right now. I don't have like a really crazy tan yet, but this one is amazing. It completely blurs out your face. It's super full coverage, and I think it's more of like a semi-matte or like a soft matte finish because it doesn't completely dry you out. And then with those primers underneath, beautiful. Then I also, this one looks disgusting, don't judge me, but you gotta squeeze it out to the thing. This is the Beauty Blender Foundation. This is a Beauty Blender Bounce Foundation, and I have mine in the shade 4.00. This one is also really, really good in full coverage. And then last but not least, when I know it's gonna be hot and humid, because in New York it gets humid and nasty, I use my CoverGirl Outlast Extreme Wear 3-in-1 24-hour full coverage foundation. This one has SPF 18, and I have mine in the shade Natural Tan 862. So this one is amazing. Nothing will get through this. Water, sweat, humidity, nothing. This, like, I've been wearing my foundation since this morning, and now it's almost 8 o'clock. It's 7:56, so it's really good, and my whole face is still popping. So yeah, so this is amazing. Now, a concealer that I've gotten obsessed with, I found this at TJ Maxx. This is the Jaclyn concealer, and I have mine in light medium yellow. This is her Perfecting Concealer, and it is so good. I may be a bit biased because I love Jaclyn Hill. I'm sorry, I know a lot of people might disagree, but I've always loved her. I followed her from the beginning, and I just love her, and I have almost all of her products because why not? I love her so much. But anyways, so yeah, so this concealer is really, really good. It's super lightweight, super blendable, and full coverage. So I love it. And this shade right now is like perfect for me to brighten up my under eye. I love this one. Now, to set right now, okay, I love this loose setting powder. This is the One Size by Patrick Starr. My only problem is, right, so before I purchased the big one, I purchased the mini. I always do that when they have minis just to make sure I like the product, like I'm gonna try something. So I always get mine in the shade Translucent. So I love this powder. This powder is amazing. So good, so blurring. I love it, right? But I hate the packaging of the big size one. I don't know what it is, but I just really, really hate the packaging. Like, the sifter is kind of like these words. That's where the product comes out of, and it's just weird and messy, so I don't like it too much. It does have a little lid. My dogs are wilding right now, sorry. So it does have like a little lid that you could cover, but once you open that lid, it's like no holds barred. So it's annoying. Once I run out of the big one, when I do repurchase it, because I will repurchase it, I love it, I'm gonna get the small size just because I like the way it disperses the product better in the small one, so like in the mini size. But this product, this powder is amazing. If you haven't tried it, go to Sephora, get the mini, and let me know in the comments down below. Or if you've tried it, let me know how good it is, because I know it's amazing. Super blurring, and it just sets your makeup so beautifully. No flashback. It's really good. And now my next setting powder is by LYS. I got this because of Juicy Jazz, and oh my gosh, when I tell you, this is the Resilience in it's translucent, but the shade is Resilience. I've hit pan on it, as you can see. I love this powder for all over the face, for underneath the eyes. I love this so much. It's so good. And I'm dying to try the bronzer stick that they have. I'm going to get that in my next trip to Sephora. So maybe, you know, we'll have a haul in like a month or two. So I love that powder. I highly recommend that one as well. Now, the last powder that I use as a setting powder, like on a day like today. Today was like humid. It was weird outside. There was like a weird overcast. So it was like hot, but then windy. It was just weird outside today. So I set with the one size underneath my eyes, and I set the rest of my face with this L'Oreal Infallible 24-Hour Fresh Wear Foundation Powder. And I have mine in the shade, 140 Golden Beige. So this, I broke the packaging, but whatever. This powder is amazing. It's foolproof, long wearing. It's waterproof. Full matte coverage, waterproof. It's amazing. This powder is so good. Before, I remember it went viral. My dogs are bugging. Sorry if you hear them, but I have a puppy now and he's so annoying. He's always barking. But anyways, so yeah, this foundation, this powder is amazing. It's great on its own as foundation. It's great as a setting powder. You take like a big fluffy brush for a setting powder. That's what I do. And I just, you know, lightly cover my face. And this with this foundation and the Hydro Milk primer, your foundation ain't coming off, girl. It don't matter if you go jump in the pool, somebody throws you in the pool. It's not coming off. Like, it's amazing. It's that good. Macho, stop. So, I have a bronzer. I found this one in TJ Maxx. I'm sure you can find it still, like, on Too Faced's website, Ulta, wherever they sell Too Faced, Sephora. I'm sure you can still find it. But this is the Too Faced Natural Chocolate Soleil Bronzer. This one is in the shade Caramel Cocoa. So I ain't gonna lie, I got it because the packaging is pink and gold. Can you even see it with this light? Let me turn my light down. Hold on, so you guys can see the packaging, because it deserves for you to see the packaging. Like, isn't it so pretty? Oh my God, I love it. I love it so much. So let's turn that light back up, because you know what we need some light. But anyway, so it's really nice. The bronzer, the color is really beautiful. It's perfect. This is the bronzer I'm wearing today. So good. So good. Now, another powder product that's like loose form is the Jaclyn Hill loose powder blush. I got mine in Love Poem, and this is a luminous rouge blush. This is the packaging. It's beautiful. This is like rose gold, little pink J. I love it so much. I love you, Jaclyn. I love you. And this is the blush shade. So it comes in a loose form. Let me just show you guys real quick. So can you even see it? Look how pretty. It's so pretty. I love this blush. Super soft and blendable. Oh my gosh. Like, it's gorgeous. So I love that blush. It's so soft. It's gorgeous. I found this in TJ Maxx. I only paid like $8 for it. I think it was like $7.99, something like that. Got a really good deal because I found it at TJ. Now, I have two like face palettes to share with you guys that I am obsessed with. I've been obsessed with these for a very long time. This is the Too Faced Natural Face Palette. The packaging, of course, is gorgeous. Too Faced has the best packaging, like the best packaging. Has a huge mirror, and then it has blush, bronzer, and highlight. So when I tell you that I abuse everything in this palette, I abuse everything in this palette. I mix the contours, bronzing shades, I mix the blushes, and I mix the highlights. This palette is absolutely gorgeous. Like, I love it. Like, this is my go-to, like, safe palette, because I know it's that good, and it smells like chocolate, so I love it even more. And then another bronzer palette I have is the BH Cosmetics Tulum palette, bronzer and highlight. So I have used all of these bronzers. I kind of just swirl my brush in all four of the bronzers. And then this, I haven't used this highlight because it's a little bit more like, I feel like if I'm going to a pool party or something like that, then I might use this one like over my bronzer just to give me like that J-Lo kind of bronzy glow. But this highlight, I love it. It's so beautiful. It doesn't have a mirror up, but that's okay. The shades are ginormous. Like, each little thing, compartment is really big. So you get a lot of bang for your buck. And I think I paid $6 because I found this at TJ Maxx. They have, like, all of these, like, different country palettes that VH Cosmetics came out with. I have a few of them. And I only pay, I think they're, like, $5.99 in TJ Maxx or, like, Marshalls and stuff. So if you see this, pick it up. It's really, really good. Just make sure nobody touched it, because that's one thing in TJ Maxx and Marshalls. People put their fingers in everything and it's annoying. So, yeah. So now, the next thing is going to be two eyeshadow palettes. I don't do eyeshadow that much anymore. I am working from home now since, like, the end of March. Anyway, so I don't really wear eyeshadow like that anymore. But when I do, these are the two palettes I pick up. And look at that. They're both Jaclyn Hill palettes. So this is the older palette. This is the Armed and Gorgeous palette, the collab that she did with Morphe. But this is my favorite. Specifically for this white shade right here. You put that white shade in your inner corner, and let me tell you, it's the best inner corner highlight that I've ever used. And the rest of the shades are gorgeous. Obviously, I've used all the other shades. This is nice. When I want to do something quick, I just put, you know, any of these transition shades. If I want to deepen it up, I use this really dark one on the outer corner. I'll pop one of these little shimmers all over the lid, and I'm out the door. Like, quick 5-minute eyeshadow. This is gorgeous, like so good. And I got this also in TJ Maxx or Marshalls, and I think I paid only $9.99 for it. Really, really good. Now, this is a newer palette of hers. This is from her Strawberry collection. Yes, this is the Strawberry Feels eyeshadow palette. This was $12.99 or $11.99 in TJ Maxx. But look at the packaging. It's pink, it's a strawberry. And then look at the inside. Like, look at those beautiful strawberry pink colors, like burgundy, these shimmers. This palette is gorgeous. Like, I've been using this one for, like, my quick every, you know, like, so, like, if I want to do some eyeshadow, I'll use this one now. So anyway, so this is the Strawberry Feels palette. It was $12.99 at TJ Maxx. Go get it. The pigmentation is there, the blendability, all of that. Jaclyn Hill knows how to do her stuff. Like, anything Jaclyn Hill is probably going to be great. Maybe I'm biased, but I don't care. I love it. I love her. So, yeah. So, now the next thing I would do would be mascara or lashes. So, mascara, both of them are really affordable. I have high-end mascaras, and yeah, they're good, whatever, but mascara is definitely something that I don't think you should splurge on. So, I have these two. This one I get in Ulta. This is the Essence Lash Princess Mascara. This is the green one. And this is the False Lash Effect Mascara. This one is my favorite one. Super, super nice. I have long eyelashes, but this makes me really look like I'm wearing falsies. So that's the wand. Some people care about the wand, but everything is good about it. They do have a waterproof version. I think that's the blue one, but I like the green one. I don't need waterproof makeup. So this one is really, really good. And then another affordable one, this one is from the drugstore. You get in Ulta or at drugstores. This is L'Oreal, the Voluminous Carbon Black Mascara. This is an oldie, but a goodie. And this one is amazing. I put this on. This is the one I'm wearing today. And it looks like I got, like, do you guys see my lashes? Yeah, like, it's good. Really, really good. I love the formula, everything about this is just perfection. It's super, super black. And obviously I have mine in, this is carbon black. So I have in the blackest, I always get blackest black or whatever the darkest in mascara is. Now, going along with the eyes, I have these lashes. So these lashes I haven't worn yet, but these are the Ioni lashes. I get these at Dollar Tree. They're $1.25. They're amazing. They have so many different ones. They're just gorgeous. So this one, I can't actually wait to wear these. They're really, really pretty. Let me see if I take it out of the package, actually. These are really, really nice. Nah, I'm still gonna have a little. But anyway, so they have so many different lashes. They have different packaging. They got all different kind of packaging. You just go and look and pick the one that you like the best, really. Because all Dollar Trees have Ioni lashes. And their lash glue is really, really good, too. My daughter really likes the Ioni lash glue, so Yes, get you some. And you can rewear them quite a few times. So I do have my favorite eyeliner right now. Most of the time, if you know, I'm not wearing eyeshadow, I'll just do black liner. And my favorite one at the moment is the One Size Point Made in Boldacious Black. And it's just a regular felt tip. It's really, really thin. You get a really, really nice black line. Look at that. When it dries down matte. It's really, really, really amazing. I love that One Size one. And I got it on sale. I think I got it for like maybe $9 or $10. And I think it costs $18. I'm not too sure. But I'll link everything I can down below. So now my next thing would be this Hard Candy Strokes of Gorgeous Oopsie Proof Makeup Eraser. So it's a makeup eraser like pen, if you can see. So if you like mess up on your eyeliner, it's just clear, really. Like it might have some black because I used it to clean up my eyeshadow, like my eyeliner. But this is just like, it's kind of like I think it's like makeup remover inside of there, and you just clean it up. And it's really good. It works really, really well. Now, for my lips, I have my favorites right now. So this is my NYX Cosmetics lip pencil in the shade Cold Brew. And it's just a deep brown shade. Obviously, I use the crap out of it because it's like small and run down. I use this today on my lips. I mean, I did eat, so my lipstick is kind of funky. But yeah, so I use this, and then I'll use my Juvia's Place lipstick in the shade Muted, and I'll put this in the middle. Blend it in, and we have a lip. So this, the packaging, like, if for nothing else, the packaging is worth it. Like, it's beautiful. It's like a beautiful ombre pink packaging. Like, what? Oh my God. It's beautiful. So yeah, Juvia's Place. I like their lipsticks. I have a few of these, but this is like my favorite one right now just because of the, you know, more brownie kind of, you know, ombre kind of lip thing. That's, you know, all the rage right now. So yeah, I love that one. And then if I'm going to use gloss, I don't like using gloss that much. I rather a matte lip, but if I do use gloss, it's going to be the Maybelline Lifter Gloss. This gloss is so good, okay? When I tell you that it is like the Fenty Gloss Bomb, I stopped buying the Fenty Gloss Bomb because of this one. Can you see it? Let me try it. I'm gonna put it on my lips, actually. Juicy. Instant juiciness. You see that? Yeah. That's why I love this. This is just a clear one, so I think this is in the shade Ice 002. But I do have a few of them. I have like the more nudie ones, like a little bit browner. I have like a tan kind of one. So, but these are really, really nice. I've seen people use like the metallic ones and they're really, really pretty. I just don't know if I would use the metallic ones, but it's really nice. I love it. So the last thing I do at the end of my makeup would be set it. So right now, my favorite, I do have two of them. I have to grab the other one. It's back there. So this is Milani Make It Last Setting Spray. I got the big jumbo size. I got this in Walmart. I ordered it online. It was $14. The regular size one is like $10, like $9.99, maybe $11 now. You get that one like in Ulta, drugstores, whatever. But this one is the jumbo size. So I'm happy I have this huge one. This one is 6 fluid ounces. It's really good. And it's amazing. It's a 16-hour wear. You could use this to prime. You could use this, and then you could use it to set. I only use it as a setting spray. I don't like to wet my face before I finish. So if that makes any sense, I don't want my face wet. But this setting spray, okay? I mean, this one is, I bought it like when it came like in that double packaging for the holidays. So this one still has product in it, but it kind of stopped coming out. So that's a little annoying, but this is amazing. Your makeup will not budge all day. This is the One Size Beauty Until Dawn Mattifying Waterproof Setting Spray. So this brings how many? 3.4 ounces. I got the set of two, but this one kind of stopped working. So I think I'm just going to get rid of this one, but I feel like there's a lot of product in there. I don't know, but whatever. But yeah, this setting spray is amazing for the summer, especially, you know, get thrown in some water. You'll be all right. Nothing's going to happen. So that was all my current favorites. I hope you enjoyed this video. If you're not subscribed, please subscribe, because I will be doing a Temu haul and a Juicy Couture collection coming up. And yeah, you don't want to miss it. And yeah, guys, again, thank you so much for watching. If you got to the end of this video, leave pink hearts, because we love all the pink over here. So yeah, if you guys like pink girly makeup, please subscribe, like this video, share, comment, all that good stuff. And yeah, guys, I will see you guys next video. Thank you so much for watching. Bye.